Meet the Team pages are a valuable addition to any website. It adds a personal touch to the company and can lend trust to visitors. Today, we are creating a minimalist team page for a website. By the end of this video, you'll have a fully responsive and beautifully designed web page showcasing team members. We'll also explore how to add a cool flip effect that reveals additional details. Before we begin, if you're new here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell to stay updated on our latest content. Let's jump right in. In the HTML, we start with the page title contained within the header tag. The CSS begins by defining rules for the container class, setting a maximum width of 1400 pixels. Padding inline and margin inline are logical properties, defining left and right padding and margins. Then comes the header. A linear gradient background adds diagonal stripes to the header at a minus 45 degree angle. If you want to learn more about CSS stripes, check out our dedicated video on creating stunning designs using CSS gradients. Similar to padding inline, padding block is another logical property managing top and bottom paddings. The H1 tag inside the header sets the font size, color, and line height for a polished look. See those cool stripes on the right side of the header? Awesome. Now let's explore the team section. It features a card layout, where each card includes a team member's image and the bio. We use CSS Grid to create a responsive layout, adjusting the number of columns based on screen width. Grid template columns ensures flexibility while maintaining a minimum width of 250 pixels. Adding a gap of 1 rem, which is effectively 16 pixels in this case, introduces spacing among grid items. The team member card is set as a grid container, designed with an aspect ratio of 1 by 1.2 for a portrait look. The aspect ratio is customized for a slightly larger appearance on wider screens. Moving forward, team member images are styled to cover the entire area. The grid area is a shorthand property that specifies the item's size and location, ensuring seamless alignment within the grid. When 4 values are specified, grid row start takes the first value, grid column start takes the second, the grid row end, and the grid column end take the third and fourth. In our case, the image container starts at the intersection of the first grid row and the first grid column, ending at the intersection of the second grid row and the second grid column. Afterward, images have the object fit rule set to cover, ensuring they maintain their original aspect ratio while covering the entire frame. A grayscale filter is applied to give them a monochromatic look. CSS filter functions are handy for changing image appearance. Besides grayscale, we can apply blur, adjust lightness, saturation, contrast, and more. Moving on, the bio section is defined as a flex container to keep its content center aligned. It features a subtle background color, maintaining contrast with the foreground. The outline property is used to add a border with an offset value of minus 15 pixels. Next, we assign the exact same grid area values as the image, ensuring they perfectly stack on top of each other. Having the same grid area makes them overlap seamlessly. We could stack them by positioning absolutely, but why not use the new CSS features instead? Now let's add the card flip effect we envisioned for this page. The first step is adding a hover pseudo class to the team member. This effect rotates cards 180 degrees around the y-axis. If we observe closely, it's flipping the image, but the bio is still hidden. If we apply transform style to the card and then add backface visibility hidden to the image and bio, it starts revealing the bio from the back side of the card. Preserve 3D indicates that the children of the element should be positioned in 3D space. And the backface visibility property decides whether the backface of an element is visible or hidden. An element's backface is a mirror image of its front. While invisible in 2D, the backface may become visible when a transformation rotates the element in 3D space. However, the bio appears mirrored. We can fix it by applying a rotation of 180 degrees. Next, we will apply the transition property to make the flip smooth. This property animates the flip effect gracefully over a time frame of 0.8 seconds. The transition delay property specifies the time to wait before starting the effect. Here's an interesting tip. Many of us may not know that the wait time can differ for the mouse over and mouse out events. In this case, the mouse over effect will be triggered instantly since the rule inside the hover block specifies a wait time of 0 seconds. However, the mouse out effect will be delayed by 0.8 seconds. Now, let's take a moment to appreciate the final version of our project. It's a fully responsive layout with a clean and simple user interface. The grid layout of team members, with images gracefully flipping at 180 degrees on hover, reveals the bios of each team member. It's a neat and engaging design, ready for seamless integration into your projects. Feel free to explore the live demo by following the link provided in the description. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more exciting web development content. Leave your questions or suggestions in the comments below. See you in the next one.